We write devices, mnemonic, so the professors won't think you're moronic. Learn Simmer songs and you'll do us proud, singing tunes while taking tests, but not out loud.
Welcome to Simmer Song 6! We hope this information sticks, because it involves a challenging topic for physiology, microbiology, and biochemistry students, glycolysis. Glycolysis is a biochemical process that produces two pyruvic acid molecules from a single simple sugar glucose molecule.
Oh, sugar! Check out his sweet tie. It's got candy.
What's your favorite candy from the tie, Dr. Simmerlein?
Definitely the M&Ms, Dr. Simmerlein.
And I like the gummy bears. And the glucose that you would take into the bloodstream from these candies eventually finds its way to the cells. This is a model of the glucose with a six-atom ring in its center, as you can see. And it has actually six carbons associated with it as well. So once it enters the cell, it needs to be locked in there. So the first step of glycolysis is for it to be phosphorylated. This is accomplished by the enzyme hexokinase. And again, locks this molecule inside the cell. We then move on to glucose isomerization. Isomerization means changing the geometry of the molecule without changing the number or types of atoms in it. Again, as we said, this has a six-atom ring in the center, but after we do isomerization, zap, it becomes a five-atom ring. And we now call this molecule fructose rather than glucose. You didn't know I was magical, did you, Dr. Simmerlein?
Yeah, wow. Check out his tie. It changed too.
Ho, 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 it's magic.
So now we're ready to move on to step two of glycolysis, which is called priming. Once again, we're going to add another phosphate to this from an ATP molecule. We've done this twice, once in phosphorylation and once in priming, so we're actually down two ATPs in this process.
Aww.
Which is weird, because we're supposed to be making energy, not losing it. But hang on, there's more coming. Once we've phosphorylated this molecule, now we're prepared with the fructose 1,6-diphosphate to undergo cleavage. No, not that kind of cleavage. This kind of cleavage, which chops that molecule into two equal pieces. Each one of those is referred to as a glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate, or a PGAL for short. You'll notice we've also removed all of the extraneous hydrogens and oxygens from the molecule, so you can really see what's going on. Now we add a phosphate, and we are going to actually remove one of these because you really don't need both of these molecules. That one's kind of unnecessary. So now we just have one here to work with. This particular molecule will pick up another phosphate group. This one doesn't cost ATP. It's kind of a freebie.
Yeah!
And now we'll move on to our fourth step, which is known as oxidation. As I said before, we've removed the hydrogens and oxygens, but so that you can see the hydrogens, we'll go ahead and zap, and there they are. So those hydrogens are actually going to be removed from the molecule by a coenzyme called nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, or NAD for short. So NAD comes along and swipes those two hydrogens right off the molecule, and NAD will then take them to the mitochondria where we'll make a bunch of ATP from those electrons that were taken with the hydrogens. Now we're ready for our very last step, which is called dephosphorylation. So two ADP molecules will come along and remove those two phosphates, so we get back an ATP from each one. But remember, we used up two ATPs to start with, so it seems like we haven't really made any energy in the process. But don't forget, we had two PGALs that went into this process, so you picked up two ATPs directly from the other PGAL, so we're now two to the good.
Yeah!
We're now ready to have our musical mnemonic for you. This one is to a tune from the hit Broadway musical Hairspray, and it is to the tune of...
I Can Hear the Bells.
So, please... Sing with us now.
ATP, you need it to survive, oh yes it's ATP that keeps your cells alive. And if your ATP production goes awry, the grisly truth is in 1 minute you'll die. And so it's
ATP that powers each heartbeat. But how is ATP made from the food you eat? The tale of ATP's synthesis, we must confess, begins with a five-step biochemical process called
glycolysis in cells.
It makes energy.
Glycolysis in cells.
That's to ATP by breaking glucose down. You'll never feel run down. You're a dynamo.
You go!
Glycolysis in cells. Is phosphorylation, and then comes
glucose
isomerization. Next, priming's
step two,
in which the new carbohydrate becomes something called fructose 1,6-diphosphate, and then
step three
cuts fructose right in two, so that in
step four
oxidation will ensue, and that leaves
step five
dephosphorylation. Strips phosphates away, and then
we're all done with glycolysis in cells.
Step one's hexokinase.
Glycolysis in cells.
Keeps glucose in its place.
And after step three slice,
please remember our advice. Steps four and five are done twice.
That's nice.
Glycolysis in cells.
Glycolysis in cells.
It makes energy.
Glycolysis in cells.
It nets two ATP
plus two NADHs. We're three ATP each. As long as mitochondria have O2 in reach. Glycolysis in cells.
It makes pyruvate.
Glycolysis in cells.
What is this acid spade without some oxygen?
It's fermentation.
Lactate buildup causes muscle irritation.
But oxygenation allows respiration.
So aerobic
and slick.
Glycolysis in cells.
Glycolysis in cells.
In cytoplasmic gels.
Cytoplasmic gels.
Glycolysis in cells.